Hey guys, welcome back to another Pirates episode. So unfortunately I had finished playing and saved it right after I viewed the footage. I realized A, the audio is unusable, and there was some weird glitching, so I had to dispose of it. So we're not where we were. We're about 45 minutes along, but I captured the town of... Well, can I... Hold on. Go to the map. Yeah, oop. I don't know if you caught it there. I captured the town of Santa Catalina and made it Dutch. And now I'm traveling up the coast to look for pirates. Really, I should have started down here, level with Gran Granada, but we started from around here, so. But there will be probably at least 3 or 4 pirates along this coast here, with the remainder being somewhere up here, probably either around St. Augustine or Havana. Anyway, and we are currently, we've only defeated one pirate. So there are 8 more out there still. Let's see, I got a promotion from the French to a major and got like 450 acres of land. I romanced some girl at Curacao, danced with her a little bit. Didn't. That's pretty much it. Oh, I forgot. We also fought the one guy from the main quest. And got a fragment of the map. Now, there's a reason I don't do the main quest. It's just because it's quite repetitive, honestly. You had to track down this guy, and he will be procedurally generated to the other side of the map. And you will chase him through about 3 towns. And you finally catch him and fight him. And he'll have this super upgraded ship. And then he'll give you a map or a piece of a map, and there's like 4 pieces, mind you, so you have to do that 4 times for one family member, and you have like 5. So anyway, with that being said, yeah, we're just gonna play, because that really annoyed me, that all the crashes and stuff. So I'm going to try to get as much crew together as possible, but I don't think I'll have enough to do what I want to do, which is attack everybody. And I named this ship the Gun Bear, because he's pretty much the only person that watches these videos. And this is for Flumpy Crekin. It's the most squid-like. Uh-oh. Oh dear. I think we're gonna have to fight. Yes! A pirate. Captain Kidd. Yeah, so he's easy. All the name pirates, ironically, are pretty dang easy. So all these cutscenes are essentially, literally the same, actually. And except for the clothing, the pirates are the same too. But look how much gold. Oh geez. Yeah, so I may lose power, so I don't know if you guys can hear that on the recording or not. Ooh, third most. See what I'm saying about all the pirates being around here? Well, they aren't mutinying because they got 10 grand more gold, so that's good. Sweet, they're about to get some more. Yeah, we'll probably maybe make, I don't know, 100 grand or so, roughly. If we get enough pirates. If we get like 2 or 3 more, that'll be about 50 or 60,000. See what I'm saying? Same thing. So I think he's the fourth most. Oh, he got moved up because I killed the other one. I guess we'll get those. We'll get them for all the name ships. We're selling that. Seriously? 53 tons? Yeah, so the auto-dying of the whenever you go around trying to capture ships, you know, I know that's a holdover from the original game. And in the original game, it works. Because of the basically increased use of your imagination, pretty much, because of the graphics not being, you know, this high level. Ooh, sweet. Okay, these are going to be crappy. They're still named pirates, though. So they're still going to have at least 1,000 gold. But almost all of them use cutlasses, so they're super slow compared to them. But yeah, see, and then it's supposed to add like tension or whatever to the gameplay, but it's just annoying because the gameplay isn't hard, even on the hardest difficulty. It's not hard. It's just basically annoying. So what you're left with is this arbitrary thing. It just doesn't perform what it's supposed to, you know, in-game. Oh, wow. We're going to get... I just saw Blackbeard or Henry Morgan, one of the two. Because those are the only two pirates, named pirates, that are in the frigates. So, yeah. This is going to be good. Plus, like... with the auto-dying thing. Like, it's so random, too. So it randomly makes the game, I don't want to say harder, but, like, it's just annoying. Because you can't gauge how difficult the fight is going to be going into the ship combat. Because everything's all procedurally generated, essentially. So it's basically random. Yeah, wow, he sucked. Wait a minute, we don't need all these cannons. Actually, we don't, you know what? Take that, let's dump all this bunch of food. We don't need more than 10 months. Yeah, that looks good to me. The sixth most, yeah, that's... So we'll go here and sell a bunch of chips. And let's see what they got. talk to the mayor, they'll give you like little quests to do. But we're already really high level with the Dutch, for one, and for two, I find those to be not fun. It's mostly just escort quests and other crap like that. I'm not playing like that. He's gonna have at least 20,000. He's pretty up there. He's number two and Blackbeard's number one. Oh, and he's fully kitted out, isn't he? Yeah, this is nice. Yeah, I mean, I guess a little thought was put into these pirates, knave pirates, but not enough, in my opinion. Yeah, about 20,000. Okay, well, he's the first one. Apparently Blackbeard's being lazy. So they're rated by how much money they've gotten, not only over the lifetime of the pirate, but also like how much they currently have. So I should say, usually, Blackbeard's number one. I guess he got edged out by Henry Morgan. Oh my gosh, they're all the pirates in the universe are right here. That's what I'm talking about. Man, we're gonna like... This is awesome. Like, even crappy speeds. This is so much faster than that other ship. Like, and I hold as much people. Like, if it wasn't for, the amount of damage the bigger ships could take, there'd literally be no reason to have big ships like that. And there isn't for me, so I'm going to sell them. Yeah, see, look, we're almost at 100,000. Oh, and now my pirates are happy. Yeah, you damn right should be happy. You just gained 70 grand. Oh, and now you're frustrated again, are you? You guys, I tell you, you're impossible to please, people. Yeah, let's try to sneak into town. So here's the sneaking thing. Obviously, you're supposed to sneak into town, but not get caught by the guards. I think this is where I'm supposed to go.
Un impatto implicativo.
Huh. Well, that was a waste of time. How about have some cannonballs, you jerks? Alright, after this we'll go up to Havana. That's gonna be fun. There should be... Yeah, either right here on the tip of Havana, or up past St. Augustine's where Blackbeard will be probably. Yeah, that's so weird. How can they be unhappy? They have over 100,000 gold pieces. I mean, I know it's how long they've been at sea or whatever, but... I mean, couldn't they just leave? They're like, hey, I want to be paid out, my share. Well, there's Havana. Yeah, I don't think he'll be down there. He might be over by Eleuthera. I'll go check that out. Eleuthera is the next town over. Next friendly town, other than St. Augustine, because that's Spanish. We might be able to see if we can pull in some more crew. But I doubt it. I think we'll have to divide up the plunder. Because at a certain point, it doesn't matter what you do. They will always be frustrated with you. Because they've just been at sea too long or whatever. It's like a mechanic in the game. So. But I should darn well get a big old promotion from this. This is a pretty decent ship. At least a bunch of land, because everybody hates those pirates. Yep. Oh, yes, that's what I'm talking about. 1,000 acres. Now, let's go over here.
Yes, we talked.
Now, let's check out... Oh yeah, that was really good. Just go ahead and damage all my ships. That fiddle will help with morale. Oh yeah, it's Grand Bahama, not Eleuthera. Eleuthera is below it. So you can send pirates out to attack other people. Now we're going to text St. Augustine. People make it British. If you outnumber the commander by a specific amount, then they will do this. Block you at the gate to the fort. They did this in the base game too. Well, next time I hit him, he'll surrender. Oh, that sucked. I better get a fat promotion from this. Oh yeah, they're rewarding everybody. Admiral, nice. 3,400 acres of land. Sweet. Dude, I wish you could get that much acreage nowadays. A pain throughout the nose. That'd be, I don't know, probably $20 million today. Maybe not where it was at. Maybe not in Florida. Well, I don't know, 3,400 acres. That's a lot of land, even in a shit town like Florida. Oh, I'm sorry. Because the entire state's one shit town. That's where Florida man lives, you know. In his wife beater shirt, drinking Natty Light. Sitting in a swimming pool in the front yard. 1980s whatever car jacked up on cinder blocks with no wheels. Yeah, I lived in Florida for a little while. Ooh, another pirate. No, he's not a main pirate though. I killed all the main pirates. Yeah, we're gonna blow him up. Yeah, how you like him? What? Seriously? I was getting all excited. Fine. See, gunnery in this game is absolutely 100% worthless. And I'm worthless at it anyway. Seriously, I was already... the dizzy thing in this game. Oh, like, I outnumber him by 50 men. Seriously? I was all the way in his belly. Yeah, I don't know if that was a glitch or whatever, but that's happened to me more than one time. I don't know if it's... I think it's the speed of the animation versus the speed of the actual attack. Like, they're not in sync somehow. So, yeah, this game is basically a remaster of the 87 version. So, if they did a remaster of this... like, it would be a remaster of a remaster, and that would be kind of weird, but... I mean, I'd play it. Yeah, I think we're gonna have to, end the episode, not end the episode, but I don't think, we're gonna divide the plunder.
Okay.
So, sorry Gunbear, we're gonna have to sell this ship, and the Kraken. 20,000. That's not bad. Yeah, we'll do adventures too. Because if you do the higher difficulty, then what happens is you have to, I think you have to get more parts for the map. For the main quest. And that ain't happening, y'all. Like, no, not at all. Like, I find that the main quest to be tedious as hell anyway. Yeah, we'll pick up a little more crew here. Sure, that's plenty.
Done anymore?
No, I'm not gonna give up most of my money for something. So the Indian stuff is basically worthless. In terms of, like, you know, what it can do in game. I think after this I'll install a couple of mods. Most of the mods are really simple, but there are some good ones that really change the nature of the game, actually. I think I talked about it previously. But yeah, we're going to end it here. See you in the next one.